and welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. With me on Skype today is Helen Tayton-Martin and James Noble, both from Adaptimmune. Great to see you.
Hi. Nice to see you too.
James, why don't you start off with giving us an introduction into this clinical stage biopharma company?
Yeah, thanks very much. So we are a cell therapy company. So we take cells out of patients and we genetically modify them and put them back into the same patients in an effort to enhance the immune system's ability to fight cancer. And we're in lots of different cancers. We have three programs going in the United States at the moment, and they're in about 12 cancers between them. So it's a very exciting business. It's at the sort of cutting edge of technology, using the body's own immune system, boosting it to fight cancer.
Well, let's talk a bit about some of the technology that the company has already in place. The company's SPEAR T-cell platform that allows T-cells to target and destroy cancer in solid tumors. Helen, why don't you just kind of walk me through that?
Sure, happy to. So SPEAR is actually an acronym for Specific Peptide Enhanced Affinity Receptor, which sounds a bit of a mouthful. But in essence, what we're doing is taking the natural T-cell receptor, the molecule on the cell surface that is designed by nature to recognize something on the surface of an infected cell or potentially an abnormal cell, and program the T cell to respond to it. And in nature, sometimes those T cells fail because that receptor, for whatever reason, can't see the cancer, can't see the cancer cell because it is recognized it as a self protein. And so what happens sometimes is that those receptors fail. And the technology that the company has been built upon for almost 20 years now, actually, is based on the idea of taking that natural receptor, modifying it slightly so it can see, it's more sticky to see that target, and putting it back inside the patient's T cells. So that's what we have to do. We make sure that that receptor is specific to the particular target from that patient's cancer that it has. So we have to screen the patients to make sure they have that protein. And it's actually also customized within a particular sort of tissue type molecule too. So we screen for those two things, and then we have a specific receptor which we put back into that patient's cells. So that's really the platform that we've been building that's now in the clinic, as James described.
Well, just last week, the company announced that it's using SPEAR in its first clinical trial called SURPASS. James, can you kind of, before we kind of talk about the clinical trial, James, can you tell me what the preclinical data says?
So what we're trying to do, as Helen explained, is to make the T cell receptor more able to recognize cancer cells. But that was what was stage one, if you like. So, and we've done that. We've got trials running with that. That's what we got our first generation molecules. What SURPASS is all about and why that is so exciting is that we have worked out preclinically that you can make these cells, when you put them back into the patient, much more potent. And we do that by not only putting in an enhanced T cell receptor, but by putting in another molecule, which is designed to make it more potent. And in vitro, in the lab, they are much more potent killers than the first generation molecules. So we'd hope to replicate that in patients. And what we're talking about is the extent to which you can kill cancer cells. So in the test tube, these are much better able to destroy cancer cells than the existing molecules. So we're hoping to see that in patients, and that's what we're announcing on this study. It's called a CD8 study because what we're actually doing in technical terms is putting a CD8 receptor onto all of the cells, and that turns many T cells, which aren't killer T cells, effectively into killer T cells.
So do you have a time frame at which you would begin enrollment of this study?
Yeah, it's open enrollment now. That's what the announcement is saying, that that's the first center in the United States will be open for enrollment. We're opening other centers over the second half this year, and so we'll be recruiting patients from now. Obviously, you have to, as Helen explained, you have to be positive for the antigen, you have to be the right tissue type. But beyond that, we're in a variety of cancers, and so we hope to be recruiting our first patients well before the end of this year.
Well, Roth Capital seems to see the value in this study and in the company in general, targeting the stock at $7 and reiterating it as a buy. What kind of hoops you need to jump through to actually get to this goal?
Well, we have to show, I think that the main things that are important are to show that you can actually defeat cancer. I mean, efficacy is everything in cancer. I think the safety profile is also very important. So that those are two of the things that that we're looking for. And the way you deal with the safety generally is you make sure the target itself is safe. We're very confident of that in this case, because we have a generation one molecule with the same target. So that's less of a hoop for this particular program, SURPASS. But after you have seen some efficacy and you've got your safety under control, then the next thing is to see durability. And what we hope is that by getting a deeper response in these cancers, you also enhance the durability. In other words, the time before the cancer, obviously you hope it never comes back, but if it does come back, you increase the time before the cancer reappears. And those are probably the main hurdles facing the company. There are some manufacturing issues that are difficult with this type of therapy. That's just general for cell therapy, because anything that's taking a cell out of a patient or blood cells out of a patient, or T cells out of a patient, and genetically modifying before putting them back in, it's quite a complicated process. So those are probably the biggest hurdles.
It's probably also worth emphasizing that operationally, having the clinical sites available, having worked the relationships, developed those relationships with our existing protocols, being ready to sort of start running is also incredibly important with this type of therapy. And I think we've got a very significant network now of investigators across the US, and actually also reaching into Europe and Canada as well, who are not only ready but also able to execute on this study, because I think execution is critical. And that's one of the things we've really focused on in the last 6-12 months, especially to bring the second gen forward rapidly.
Yeah, and I think most companies focused on cell therapy are actually in something called CAR T cells, which have shown great efficacy in blood-borne tumors, hematological tumors like lymphomas and leukemias, but they've for some reason not been effective in solid tumors. Now, 90% of cancers are actually solid tumors. So if you think about lung cancer or colorectal or pancreatic, and for reasons which I don't think are entirely understood, we've had good success with T cell receptors, the Spear T cells in solid tumors, and that's where the excitement is about. We've had great results in a horrible form of solid tumor called synovial sarcoma, and we've had hints in ovarian cancer and lung cancer where we've seen tumors reduced, but probably not enough. So the great hope for the SURPASS study is we turn those hints of efficacy of tumor reduction into much greater reduction, where you really will be efficacious.
Well, I am definitely looking forward to following the progress of the SURPASS study. Thank you both so much for your time today.
Thank you.
Thank you.